This afternoon is a privilege to share with you some encouragement from the Word of God before we journey another year, 2020. Are we blessed? Okay, Happy New Year, and indeed we are blessed. And so, I believe more than anything that we experienced this year, God has far greater blessing, far greater plans for all of us this coming year. Do you believe that? Yes. And so, maybe siguro first week or second week ng January, we resume to our routine, work and, diba, and schooling. So before that happen, I would really encourage you to find time to, number one, reflect. Reflect what God has done into your life this year, 2019. Reflect answered prayers. Reflect the things that God has done to you, to your family. For example, answered or fulfilled promises. Another is, I encourage you to plan, to set goals for the next year or the next 5 years. I encourage you to think of the things that you want to accomplish. At the same time, though we plan, though we have our own personal direction, let's ask the Lord, because ang plan ni Lord, ang direction niya is supreme. His plan is way better than ours. And He is God. We do not know kung sa'y may tabo, di ba? And so every year, me and my wife, we do, we call it PDP or Personal Development Plan. Before New Year, we spend time with the Lord. Pero before pa ng New Year, siguro days or weeks before, we reflect kung sa ang promises ni God na gusto na mo i-claim for the next year. And so after na mag-seek mi kay God, before Christmas or before New Year, we would discuss kung ano yung mga gispeak ni Lord. Tapos, we will write those verses and promises. And we will make a declaration for the next year. For example, ito yung promise ni God. And I will declare, Lord, I declare blessing, anointing for my family. I declare good health. Ganon. And throughout that year, kasi ipopost mo yan kung saan mo makikita always. Throughout that year, it will help you remember what God promised to you. And ma-amaze ka na ma-answer na siya, not in your own terms, but greater. Kasi si God ang nag-answer. So, are you excited to face 2020? Amen! Especially may bagong venue tayo. Another is, I would like to really appreciate God sa gibuhat ni God this year, 2019. BCI is highly communal church, but ang transition na nahitabo this year, 2019, God all the more put hunger for most of us to reach out, to really share the gospel. Even though dili pagyud tanan, but people, pastors, leaders are really coming out to share the gospel. And that's a breakthrough for the church. That's a breakthrough. So this afternoon, I would like to share with you a person who is called by the Lord to share the gospel to the Gentiles. And I believe, kabaluta or kailata na, di ba? Si Apostle Paul. This afternoon, let's look at the life of Apostle and his ministry. And from there, we can see kung unsa ang ma-learn nato as we journey in the year 2020. So we look at his life and his ministry. and the challenges and how He responded sa challenges. So let's open our Bible, 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 7 to 18. Verse 7 to 18. But we have this treasure in jars of clay, to show that this all-surpassing power is from God and not from us. We are hard-pressed on every side, but not crushed, perplexed, but not in despair, persecuted, but not abandoned, struck down, but not destroyed. We always carry in our body the death of Jesus, so that the life of Jesus may also be revealed in our body. For we who are alive are always being given over to death for Jesus' sake, so that His life may also be revealed in our mortal body. So then, death is at work in us, but life is at work in you. It is written, I believe, therefore I have spoken. Since we have the same spirit of faith, we also believe and therefore speak, because we know that the one who raised the Lord from the dead will also raise us with Jesus and present us with you to Himself. All this is for your benefit, so that the grace that is reaching more and more people may cause thanksgiving to overflow to the glory of God. 16, therefore we do not lose heart. Though outwardly we are wasting away, yet inwardly we are being renewed day by day. For our light and momentary trouble are achieving for us an eternal glory that far outweighs them all. Last, so we fix our eyes not on what is seen, but on what is unseen. Since what is seen is temporary, but what is unseen is eternal. So that passage is a powerful reflection of Paul's faith to God and his ministry. So I think the title of the message is Inner Strength, Eternal Perspective. Inner Strength, Eternal Perspective. So as we face 2020, it's my prayer that we do not lose heart. We'll move. We'll pursue what God called us to do. Whether that's a work, a ministry, a family, because the Lord is with us. We have this inner strength and eternal perspective. And so we look at Paul. Paul wrote the letter to the Corinthian Christians or to the Corinthian congregation around 52 or 53 AD. And so the first Corinthian was written by Paul when he was in Ephesus. He was ministering to Ephesus, the church in Ephesus. And second Corinthian letter was written when Paul was in Macedonia. And so Paul addresses many problems. Daghang problema sa church of Corinth. Among the problems are, number one, damaged relationships. Is that common to our churches? Diba? In the church mismo, diba? Damaged relationships. Number two, damaged relationships in a sense na there are division. Kasi naisa ka report ni abot kay Paul, he said, I follow Apollos, the other one, I follow Peter, the other one, I follow Paul or Christ. So there is a division within the church. And isa lang to siya na concern. There are a lot more. Number two, there is what we call sexual misconduct. The church tolerated sexual immorality. And in his letter, Paul, grabe, gitirada gito niya ang person. Number three, abuse in worship. there's a problem that time because a lot of people sa church, ang background nila is idolatrous culture. And so when they became Christians, they don't know the rules and regulation of a proper worship. And so, there's a problem. And lastly, this is personal to Paul, rejection of Paul's apostolic authority. Rejection to Paul's apostolic authority. In fact, there are a lot of leaders question Paul's leadership in the church. And so we can see na Paul, when he wrote that letter, he was not in Corinth, but lahi na church. From there, napod siya church na gi-establish prior pa sa Corinth. And another church, different churches has different concerns, di ba? Another is that Paul had to take care of his team. Kasi they are a team. Missionary journey ni Paul, dili siya lang, but he has a team. He has to consider all their needs and the relationships among them. Sometimes may problems sa relationships. And lastly, there are, aside sa Church of Corinth, there are criticisms sa mga leaders from different church towards Paul. They discredit Paul and his ministry. So if we look at that scenario, Paul is really grabbing pressure, no? Pressure from the inside and also from the people. Persecution inside the church and persecution outside. If we can remember in the book of Acts, whenever Paul preached the gospel, there is intense opposition to the point of death. So Paul described this in 2 Corinthians 4. Balik ta sa verse. In 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 7, we have this treasure in jars of clay. Treasure in jars of clay. We are the clay. Or other translation, earthen vessel. We are the vessel. Naintindihan yung, we are the vessel of the Lord. We are fragile. We are weak. Easily broken. Dali ra gito maguba. Diba? Dali ra ta ma-discourage. Dali ra ta makapoy. This is who we are. This is the characteristic of our earthly body living in this fallen world. And so, but Paul did not focus on the clay. Kasi tanaw na to, ha? But we have this treasure in jars of clay. Paul focus, we can see that makita na to ang jar, but Paul does not look at the jar in itself, but the treasure inside that jar. And who is or what is that treasure? That is the Lord Jesus Christ. That is the Lord Jesus Christ. We can read in Colossians 1 verse 27, it says, to them God has chosen to make known among the Gentiles the glorious riches of this mystery, which is Christ in you, the hope of glory. That is Christ in us. Paul recognizes the weakness and he described that as jars of clay. All of us are jars of clay. And so Paul continue. There is a pattern in the verse. Pattern. Verse 8. We are hard pressed on every side but not crushed. We are hard pressed but perplexed but not in despair. Persecuted but not abandoned. struck down but not destroyed. We always carry around in our body the death of Jesus, so that the life of Jesus may also be revealed in our body. There is this pattern for the clay. But the other side is the response. Pattern and response. Verse 8, Paul recognizes that there is so much pressure. Sabi niya, I am pressed hard. We are pressed hard. But ano ang respond niya? But not crushed. Press hard but not crushed. If we can see, kanang jar, kung i-pressure na ni Mugmayo, unsa may hitabo? Mag-crack, di ba? Hinahinay siya na mag-crack until such time, madugmok yun siya. If you put pressure in every side. But the illustration of Paul, we can see, in that jar, there is pressure every side. Naay mga crack, but wala siya na crush. Nakita na itong picture? Because of the treasure inside. That is so amazing. And so, move forward. Perplex. Gitanaw na ako ng perplex, ang ingon ni Maya, magulo. So, kanang, unsa may bisayanin, no? Perplex, but not in despair. The reality is perplex, chaos, or chaotic, or kanang dilema, confusing, but the response ni Paul, not in despair. Why? He knows whom he is serving. He knows his mission. He knows his direction. Especially this coming 2020, let us not lose heart. No? Naay mga confusion, naay mga challenges. We may be kanang pressed hard, perplexed, but we are not in despair. Next, persecuted. The persecution is outside and inside. Persecution from the unbelievers whenever he shared the gospel, but also so much persecution in the inside whenever he starts to correct. No, whenever he kana na siya i-discipline, whenever he tends to guide the church, na yung mga opposition. So there's persecution, but unsay respond niya? Not abandoned. That's the promise of Christ to those who follow Him. I will never leave you nor forsake you. I am with you even to the end of the age. And that's the promise for us this coming 2020. And so, struck down but not destroyed. Parang knocked down but not knocked out. No, knocked down, natumba, pero balik gyapon. Fight gyapon. Fight the good fight of faith. Struck down but not destroyed. The response is, he is not destroyed. One thing Paul make assured that, kung basahon nato diri sa verse 2, di kasi ang context ani is ministry. Life ni Paul and the ministry. Kung basahon to sa verse 1, therefore, since through God's mercy, we have this ministry. All of us are ministers. Do you believe that? All of us are ministers. Sabi pa ni Pastor Mel, every member a minister. If you have a family, that is your first ministry. And if you, of course, wherever you are, sa work, sa unsa na organization, that is your ministry. And so, Paul made sure that no sin will hinder him as he obeyed the Lord. Kasi, these challenges are outward, di ba? Kaning persecution, perplex, struck down, outward ni siya na challenges. Pero, if there is sin, then Paul and his ministry will be destroyed. External challenges cannot destroy you because of the treasure that is inside you. but the sin will. Look at this, verse 2. Rather, we renounce secret and shameful ways. We do not use deception, nor do we distort the word of God. On the contrary, by setting forth the truth plainly, we commend ourselves to everyone's conscience in the sight of God. That's very clear. Paul continued in the ministry pure. He did not allow any sin. He did not allow any corruption. Though, grabe ang revelation na gihatag ni God sa iyaha. And yet, grabe po ang paghumble ni God sa iyaha. The same with us. Problems, challenges cannot put us down. But sin will. And so, I love what God has done sa BCI. Especially this year. Transition into small group. Small group will help us be more accountable to one another. Small group will strengthen that bond so that we will not be bandaged into sin. So let's go back. And so the pattern, moto siya, pattern and response. Pattern and response. Another is verse 10 to 12, dying to self, but life flowing out of death. 10 to 12, verse 10 to 12. And verse 14, verse 11, endangered but opportunities for Jesus to be seen. So there is that physical negative thing, pero there's this result that purifies that person, no? Si Paul. And so, last year, 2019, we have a lot of challenges, no? It could be unclear direction, discouragement, unanswered prayers. Actually, kami ni Maya, we really prayed na 2019, magka-baby na. But, by God's grace, wala man budmi na discouraged, but we long for it. Somehow, that's an answered prayer, di ba? Like, Lord, I thought last year, parang nga na ba? And so, as I relate to the message, when Paul said, do not lose hope, that's where I nagid kay God tanan. I mean, whatever you do, ang pinaka-last say is si God. So sometimes, relationship problems in the family. So God would say to you, do not lose hope. Problema sa anak or unsang challenges. Lack of financial provision. Have you experienced that this year, 2019? Diba? Lord, pamiliti na lang. No challenges. Unmet expectations. Like in the world. Frustrated ka kasi you've given your best, but there's unmet expectations. And lastly, frustrations in the ministry. Have you experienced that this year? Have you cried to the Lord? Lord, ano man eh? I've served the church. Nag-serve ko sa mga, but why am I experiencing this? Frustration in the ministry. And Paul would say, the Lord will say, do not lose heart. This is for all of us, especially this coming year. We do not know, di ba? A lot of shaking, earthquake, and also personal life, a lot of shaking sa ministry, sa family. But God will always say to us, do not lose hope. Why? Because we have this treasure that dwells in us. That is the presence of the Lord Jesus Christ through the Holy Spirit. And so let's continue. Pattern and response. Next is product. What would be the result? Why God allowed that as challenges as a clay, no? Kanang clay pata, we experience these challenges, pressure in every side, and it tends to crush us. But why does God allow this? Ngano'ng ginaallow man ni God? Una, so that our faith will increase. Our faith will increase. 2 Corinthians 'Since we have the same spirit of faith,' that is in verse 13. Same spirit of faith. Ang faith ni Paul, gisulti niya, same lang po sa uban na believer. And so, and also, we believe like Paul and the other believer. And so, through that experience, pattern of challenges sa atoang life, we experience that growth of faith. So, God allows that kanang clay na mag-crack and maunsa na siya so that ato ang faith not just mag-grow but will all the more hold on to the treasure that is inside, that is the Lord Jesus Christ. Ikaduha, the product, pattern, product, the product is fruitful ministry. Fruitful ministry. Verse 15. Fruitful ministry. All this is for your benefit. Ang struggle na na-experience ni Paul is for the benefit of those who believe in Christ, for those who are in the congregation, for those who are Christians. Why? Because they will see Paul overcome the challenges. And so Paul says, imitate me as I imitate Christ. And so Paul, when people, the church, the members saw that Paul overcame the challenges, they will also imitate that. Ang life ni Paul, i-imitate po nila. So therefore, there's what we call fruitful ministry. Kasi ang mga tao, ilang faith na grow po. Nag-grow ang faith ni Paul because of the challenges, and the people saw that, but si Paul, wala siya na napildi, no? Wala siya nag-fail. He endured it and overcame the challenges. And so, the people will see that, and all the more put their faith in God. And also, ang hitabo, faith sa mga tao nag-increase. So that is fruitful ministry. Ministry is not just about numbers. Dili lang siya number, but the quality of people in the church. Ministry is not just about attendance, but it's about also commitment. Commitment not to the people, but to God. And so lastly, we do not lose heart. Why? Paul gave us more reason not to lose hope, not to lose heart. 16, though outwardly we are wasting away, yet inwardly we are renewed day by day. That is the love of the Lord for us. That is the love of the Lord for us. Sometimes weary kayo ka sa challenges, but the Lord will speak to you. In the morning, or in the midst of the challenges, a small still voice magminister sa imuha. You are renewed day by day. We are renewed day by day. So we do not lose hope. We do not lose heart. Verse 17, another reason, for our light and momentary troubles are achieving for us an eternal glory that far outweighs them all. There is an eternal glory. There is greater glory than what we experience in this earthly life. That is eternal perspective. Eternal perspective. We look upward, not with the problems. Kanina, inner strength, because of the Lord Jesus Christ, the treasure inside that jar, karon, eternal perspective, because there is a coming glory far greater than what we experience today. And lastly, this is Paul's command to the believer. So we fix our eyes not on what is seen. What is seen many times discourage us. What is seen many times cause us to doubt God's promises. But we fix our eyes on what is seen because we fix our eyes on what is unseen because what is unseen is eternal. So therefore, for all of us, this coming 2020, just let us remember na we have this inner strength that is the Lord Jesus Christ, and we have this eternal perspective that is the coming glory of God. We will not lose hope. Even if right now you have experienced challenges, na wala pa na human, 20, hapit na mag-2020, you have still that challenges, I invite you to surrender that to God. So this moment of time, let us ponder what God has done, and let us really come to the Lord and ask Him the things that you want to say, especially this coming 2020. The Lord has a curriculum for all of us, for each one of us, a curriculum, a process for each one of us. And always that process or curriculum is for His glory, for His glory. Let's come to the Lord and seek Him. Let's pray individually. Let's talk to Him. Lord, what are the promises that You have given to me? Lord, what are the things that You want me to do? Lord, what are the things in my life or in my family that You want me to surrender? Lord, thank You so much, Lord, for all that You have done for us. Lord, as You allow things to happen in our life, we believe that that is the best for us. Because You are our Father, You know what is best for us. Lord, this year 2019, we surrender everything to You. Lord God, we surrender. Lord, kung if ever napaman nabilin, God, sa mong heart that hinders my relationship to You, Lord, I surrender it to You. Lord God, I look forward for the greater glory that You are about to reveal to me, to my family, to this church. Lord, I look forward for greater understanding of Your word. Lord, I look forward for more intimate experience, God, of You. Lord, I look forward for more fruitful ministry ahead of time this year. Lord, I look forward for the answers, Lord, of my prayers, because You are our loving God who will indeed answer all of our prayers. Lord, this is for Your glory and honor. We belong to You. You belong to us. We thank You, God. We belong into this family. Lord, we bless Your name. Indeed, Lord, BCI will continue to expand. We will serve. Our family will serve. Lord, we will commit. We will commit to love You all the more and to serve You and Your people. We honor You, Lord God. We honor You, Lord Jesus. We pray in Christ's name. Amen.